All systems are still a go for the Shuttle Endeavour, with this morning's launch still set for 8:56. And you will see it live right here on News Channel 5.
We have the largest local news team in place inside and outside of the Kennedy Space Center for today's historic launch. Jake Hashmir is inside the Kennedy Space Center. Lauren Lapenzina is outside with the crowds at Port Canaveral.
So let's start outside with Lauren. How big are the crowds, Lauren? Good morning.
Good morning, John and Roxanne. Good morning, everyone. They are definitely building as the sun starts to peek through out here. We're at a beautiful spot just outside the gates to Jetty Park, right here at the water's edge. The shuttle glowing off into the distance. When we first arrived, everybody was kind of still sleeping in their campers and tents and RVs, but they are up and at them now. The anticipation is building, and they're expecting about 500,000 total out here today. Back on April 29th, when we tried to launch Endeavour the first time, they were expecting about 700,000. So a little bit smaller, but still at 500,000 people, not too shabby. What's really struck us out here in talking with folks just in our little area here is just how much time and how much money they have invested in coming here to see Endeavour's final launch. We have met people, John and Roxanne, from Germany, from St. Louis, from West Virginia, from Maryland, that have come here today just to have front row seat to history today in terms of NASA and the shuttle program. One of the diehards, as I call them, is Scott Bidwell. He's here with us this morning in his official NASA t-shirt. Good morning.
Absolutely. Good morning, Lauren. How are you?
I'm great. Scott is here from Maryland and has quite an interesting launch story to tell. Tell us your story.
Oh, well, I was here 2.5 weeks ago. I flew down for this flight. And needless to say, it was scrubbed, and I ended up flying back home. And this is so pretty much on my bucket list. I have to do it. I only have one more shot after this. So
you flew back.
I flew back and then flew back down here again. And hopefully it's going to go up this time.
You have a good feeling about it?
Oh, absolutely. You know, we're gonna pull it off this time around, you know?
Great to meet you, Scott.
Oh,
thank you so much. Don't you love that? He said it was on his bucket list. I just love that. So 4 plane tickets later, Scott is here with us this morning and all the rest of these 500,000 folks just to see Endeavour's 25th and final launch. For more now of our team coverage and more about the mission itself here to the ISS, I'm going to toss things over to my colleague Jay Hashmir, who is inside the NASA gates and on NASA grounds. Jay, good morning.
Good morning to you, Lauren. A lot of anticipation here inside Kennedy Space Center as well. We're at the media press site as we speak. More media showing up as we speak. Over my left shoulder, you can see the countdown clock well underway. 2 hours to go before the launch of Space Shuttle Endeavour. 39A, the launch pad right out there. We're awaiting a beautiful sunrise right now. The forecast right now, 70%. No major issues. Weather-related, there was a crosswind issue last night. Local meteorologists were predicting about 10 to 15 mile an hour gusts. That doesn't appear to be an issue. It's not breezy at all right now here on site, so all indications are this is set and ready to go. Otherwise, no significant technical issues either from NASA. Currently, Space Shuttle astronauts are boarding Endeavour as we speak. They made their way out to the launch pad about 40 minutes ago, and at 6:56, the crew and the hatch will be closed, and it will be locked, and then, of course, they'll go through about two hours of systems checks up until a blast-off at 8:56. The importance of this mission is huge. The last mission of Space Shuttle Endeavour, of course, the second to last mission for the Space Shuttle program here. This is the 25th and final mission of Endeavour. They'll be blasting off on a 16-day mission to the International Space Station. 4 spacewalks are planned under the command of Commander Mark Kelly. His wife, Congresswoman Gabrielle Giffords, is at a secure location right now on site. She will witness the launch with other astronauts, family, and friends and relatives. So we are standing by waiting for this launch this morning. Should be a beautiful launch right now. The Cape shaping up to be a gorgeous morning out here. We'll be live. Coming up at 6:45, we're going to tell you what's important on this mission that won't happen on the next mission of Space Shuttle Atlantis and why it's so important. That coming up at 6:45. For now, we are live at Kennedy Space Center. I'm Jay Hashmir. John and Roxanne, back to you.